Scott. Look, I know you've just closed your latest case, but I need your help. We just discovered a dead body in Central Park, and I think you'll want to come take a look.
A hell of a sight to behold, isn't it? This pile of leaves prevents us from properly identifying the body, so I think your best shot is to come and inspect the crime scene in person.
Sandra Parsons, at your service. Well, hello. I've already done the initial examination, but I've left everything in its place, so you can examine everything on your own. You should examine the body first, so we can take it back to the lab and do an autopsy, and then we'll start looking at the other evidence. Detective Matthews has already begun interviewing the witnesses who found the body.
Hello, I'm Daniel Smith. Just how many people are going to interrogate me? Otto and I were colleagues and good friends, so I knew him really well. I still can't believe he's gone. Otto and I loved going for morning runs in the park. Today we were supposed to go too, but I smelled something fishy when Otto didn't show up at our usual meeting time this morning. No way! Otto was a decent and hard-working man. He wouldn't hurt a fly! His directness annoyed some of his colleagues, but he always had good intentions and did his job to the best of his ability. It breaks my heart to see my friend like this. If it's all right with you, officer, I'd like to go home and grieve in peace. I hope I've managed to help you a little bit. Good luck with your investigation.
Take these. You'll need them later.
The bruises around the victim's neck indicate strangulation. We conclude that the murder occurred yesterday at around 5 p.m. The crime weapon seemed to be a thin, durable object. I assume you've already examined the body. If so, you can take it to the coroner's office. Once they complete the post-mortem report, you'll receive it via email.
The victim was in the park around 5 p.m. on the day of the murder. He was wearing athletic shoes and a tracksuit. He was jogging. The killer was waiting for him, clearly knowing that the victim always jogs the same route. The killer stayed in the camera's blind spot and waited until the victim reached him. Then, he suddenly attacked the victim from behind and strangled him with a shoelace. Still taking your time, eh? While you've been dawdling, I've already determined the victim's identity. It's Otto Hudson, a 36-year-old architect, single. His colleague and close friend, Daniel, discovered his body during his usual morning run. What's your take on this? What's our next step? I have to admit, that does make sense. Let's get to work then. How about I inspect Otto's apartment while you pay a visit to his workplace? Then we'll meet and go over what we found. Two ace detectives are better than one, right? I'll catch up with you later. For now, take this. I'm sure you'll make good use of it.
You have no right to decide for the whole Bureau. The deed is already done, which means we have to deal with the consequences. Hello, who are you? Oh, a detective. Something really terrible must have happened then. I'm the director of the Architectural Bureau, and Laura is one of the staff. So, What's a detective doing here on a day off?
I saw him just yesterday at work. We were working together on a new project. Odo had a very bad temper, which sometimes caused him problems at work, but I can't believe anyone would kill him.
He was such a troublemaker, and not very competent either. Look, search the Bureau if it's necessary for your investigation, but I have to run to a meeting. Laura will find the keys to the office for you. Take a look at the computer in there. I imagine there's some camera footage on it you might find useful.
I understand that this is your job and every detail matters, so I should probably tell you. I was just about to quit this job because it wasn't really working out, but before I could pick up my things, I ran into the director. Here, take this. The room is on the top floor. You can use the elevator to get there faster. I hope you'll find the one who did this to him.